It's a strange day. The roses are in bloom, but in a strange way. I know somehow we're doomed. Look around through the town, not a soul to be found. In silence, not a sound. There's no one around but you. In the back of the car, on our way from the bar. In silence, here we are. Reminding us how we do. What can't say, it's time we come to the end. We circle around our doom. And I won't stop, not till I get what I want. And all that I want is you. In a strange place, when the sun goes down, we move into a strange phase. Like we've got nothing left to lose. So we slip through the town with our heads in the clouds. In silence, not a sound. For miles and miles around, fall asleep in the park. Underneath all the stars, in silence, here we are. Reminded of how we're doomed. Can't say, it's time we come to the end. We've circled around our doom. Yeah, I won't stop, not till I get what I want. And all that I want is you. Thank you.
Oh man, that song's fucking chill as fuck. What up, gamers, and welcome to the chill Craig's Cozy Corner stream where we're chilling and chilling. That was Crosses by That was Bermuda Locket by Crosses. Before that was Tonight Tonight by Smashing Pumpkins, and before that was also by Crosses, the Epilogue. Hope that told you enough about it. Hi. Thank you, Kay Graham. Also, May Gain. Kay Wishes. So Da. Whispers. Kalmia. Hallow Decay. Miss Doodles. Summer Wise. 123 DS2. Gabium. Trinity Vince. Beto. Lukewarm Garbage. Nyanta. Madame X. Max on Tracks. Bubzu. Tringos, Gintaro Kun, the Blue Rose, God, a lot of you guys popped out tonight. Hi. Blue Rose Yuzuki, Kiwi Panda, Embryo, Zambi Server. I'm sorry, Zambi Sever. Nope, it was Zambi Server. Stoatic. Thank you very much, guys. I haven't seen Spin in the Bottom Corner for like 5 years. Can't stay for a while, gotta work in less than an hour. Just stopping by to say hello. Well, hi, man. What up? Hopefully you have a good time at work. What stories are we reading? All right, guys. I was thinking. What about... Because this is Reddit. No, I'm sorry. This is Twitch. So we can just straight up live browse for a good story on Reddit. I'm a little quiet. Am I really? Here, I'll move the mic over here like this. Is that better? Is that good? Is that fine? How about... There we go. Okay, good. Alright, cool. So, I even went smart about this shit, okay? So, here's my Reddit, okay? Normally it'd be like this. Here's the thing. I went and got an add-on to make sure this would be the pinnacle of shit. So, I went and looked at I'm at the top of, past month for the no sleep right now. We were gonna browse, you know? Also, funny story about this one. After the 420 stream, I saw this this article because I was looking at some no sleeps. And I saw this, and I didn't realize that it was actually a no sleep. And I was like, huh, wow, a Tyson's Boards member got held for ransom. That's crazy. That's super. I'm surprised I didn't hear about that until just now. And then I realized once I read the comments, I went into the comments and it said, I was expecting, you know, people like being seriously talking about it. They were like, this was actually fantastic. I'm like, how is that fantastic? That's really bad. That's not good, man. And then it immediately clicked. So yeah, it was pretty funny. Just thought I'd share. Oh man, and oh, I also got some music. I got some creepy music planned. I searched creepy. I searched creepy. And I got this. So I figured it might work. You know, it sounded good. Let me know what you think. It sounds like nice and like, you know, it'll get there. Give it a second to kick in. Okay. Yeah. See? It's getting there. It's pretty creepy, huh? Ooh, you hear that? Ooh. That'd be fun to read creepy shit too, yeah? This shit right here will get... Here, you know what? Leave him pull up the boop. We can either have that or... I got... Here's the thing. I was smart about this. Oh, hold on one second. I have a small boy here.
I got confused and almost gave you $99,
Fuck.
Dad. Jeez. Stop stealing my money. But also, here's my money. Love you.
Love you too, boom. Smooches. Sorry about that. I don't mean to steal your money. I just got sticky fingers. I'm going through puberty, you see. Anyway, what I did was I went and found a reader add-on for Firefox to make it really good. Ambient thunderstorm sounds. Hey, if you can find me a good track, just send it to me on Discord. Feel free. I went and got an add-on. So check how this looks now. All right, so this is how it normally would look. See, that's not bad, but for reading, it's a little small and like kind of hard. But press this little button here. Boop. Bam, this shit's like a fucking Kindle. However, I don't really know how to customize it. I know apparently you can do some shit to it, but yeah, it makes it nice. It's too bright. I know. I'm trying to figure out how to tweak that, but I can't figure it out. Because like, you go here, manage extension, and it's like, hey, you can do shit like 16 million color. It's like, all right, motherfucker. Well, right now I got white. How do I get the other color? Like, you didn't even put the S. Shit. Dark mode? Well, I don't want dark mode. I just wanted to, like, maybe, like, put it down to... Is that too loud, by the way? I could lower that. Alright, let me see this, buddy. Thank you, Akira. Akira-dutun. I probably shouldn't open links like that. That's really dangerous. Oh, shit. Never mind. Sorry about doing that. Oops. Hold on. Hang on, guys. This... I'm in dangerous waters right now. Maybe a bit loud? Alright. I'm not gonna click any more links from chat, no offense, except from, trusted source here, okay, that'll be fine too. Okay, so, oh, that's the same one. Alright, okay. Okay, cool. Wait, what am I doing with myself? Why do I have, like, multiple windows right here? Hang on, chat. Alright, so... Alright, we have that, we also have this. That's nice. In the left. I thought theme is just like this is just like straight up my Firefox theme though, you know? Right? I really like this sound. Ooh. That is so comfy. I'm gonna save this for future use. We're gonna probably use this a lot for creating streams, guys. Oof. Oh, that's a good one. I'm even putting that in my business tab. That's how important that one is. Hell yeah. Oh my god, I'm getting too cozy now. Alright, hold on. I'm gonna try tweaking this shit. I don't know how this is gonna look. I don't know what's gonna happen. But we'll see. I don't know. Alright. Boop. And boop. Yeah, it didn't do nothing. Yeah, I'm not sure about actually, go to your desktop.search bar, type invert, and click on color filters. Okay. Invert. Hang on, I'm gonna go ahead and do that off screen so you don't see when I type I, it goes to, I don't know, invertednippleporn.net. You never know. What would it be? Invert. Shit, I already forgot what you said, man. I memed too hard there. Let's see. Type invert and click on color filters. Oh, I'm on freaking Firefox. Just in case that changes anything. I don't know if it does. It very well might. It probably might. I use Firefox like a fool. Invert. It inverts everything on your screen. Going inverted nipple mode. I would love to go inverted nipple mode right now. Would love to. Reading stream? Yeet. Hell yeah, dog. Sadly, ilovefurries.com doesn't exist. You can fix that XXFangirlXX7. Believe in yourself. Hold on a second. Can you do that if the text is too small? It's not that I'm trying to make the text small. I'm trying to actually make the text on like a good... aesthetically pleasing thing to see, like, for myself to read, so it's a comfortable read, you know, kind of like how you want to read on, like, you know, the tan paper kind of feel, the lifelike paper look feel, like a Kindle. You get what I mean? Can I turn the rain up a bit? Yeah, sure. What's up, Insano, my man? Ooh, that I might have put that a bit too loud, actually. Oh my god, you guys are doing that a lot. Oh, wow. What's the extension called? It's called Reader. I believe it's called Reader anyway. Yeah, just called Reader on Firefox. Oh god, you guys, sure. See, this is what you fuckers are doing right now. Okay. Isla Furries. Okay. OBS filter capture color correction. Well, no. It's not that I wanted to do that on OBS. I'm trying to do that for myself through the Firefox filter. That's what I'm trying to do right now. It's not really for you guys. It's more of just for my own eyeballs. Because I don't want to strain my eyeballs trying to read and then flub my words while I'm trying to strain. You know what I feel? Why do you guys do this to me? All right, let's see here. What if I do invert on here? Oh. Yo, I think I found it, guys. Hold on. Invert colors. Add. Okay, hold on. I think I finally found what they were talking about. I think I was being really stupid. And I think it should be okay. Ooh, no, I do not like that. Ooh, no. Well, maybe, I mean, you know, I don't know. You know, actually, is it okay? Actually, you know what? That isn't bad. Maybe even zooming in a bit. I'm not opposed to that. Yeah. Not bad. It's too dark, to be honest. I mean, I'd like to do more customizations to it. Alex just tweeted a wholesome tweet. I fucking love wholesome tweets. Oh god, I hate that's invertedness right now, but fuck it. I just had... Wait, I'll read it in Alex's voice. I just had a little girl knock on my door, holding up a bag of snacks towards me. It took her a good 5 seconds to realize I was not the person. Itadakimasu, nor the room she was looking for. Poor thing, she got flustered and ran away, speaking in French. She must have been 8 years old. Huh? Oh, good old Alex. Love him. Like. Nice. Anyway, yeah, so I don't know how to freaking... Like, dude, alright, listen. This motherfucker right here. Do you see this shit? Listen, Reader is the ultimate reader tool. Alright, motherfucker, how do I customize you then? 16 million color. How do I do it, man? I just really want to do it so bad. Try right-clicking on the reader status bar. I tried that, actually. See? It does this, and then, like, it just says manage extension, which just brings me to this menu, which I'm already at. And remove, or, like, well, I don't know what to do. Customize? That just does this thing. This is, like, the toolbar shit. You know? That's just how... That's Firefox. That's not what we want here, chat. You know, it's a fucking mystery how to actually customize Firefox add-ons. You know what I mean? Who actually uses Firefox other than friggin' me these days? There's a settings tab right there. Right here. And it really looks like that does anything. You know what I mean? First, yeah, it's like, is it raining? Yeah, dude, there's a monsoon over here. Wink. Am I a furry? No, but I have jerked off to furry porn. I'm just being honest. I think a lot of people can probably openly admit to that. They don't want to. They're gonna say, ew. They're gonna dance game. But I'm sure... There are a handful of people who are not furries, but they have jerked off to something that would be considered furry porn. You know? And that's okay. That's fine. You're allowed to do that, guys. As long as it's not, like, weird ones. Like, you know, I'm talking about, like, fucking Lola Bunny here. Alright? Here, let me get a tasteful Lola Bunny before y'all are prudes. Alright? Tasteful Lola Bunny. All right, put it this way. Okay, this is the image. Okay, bear in mind we're going to go back. Okay, close your eyes, everyone. Everyone, stop your prejudices, stop your shaming. Go back to when you were a child. Go back to when you were, let's see, when before you lost your fucking innocence and before you all became degenerates. When was that? Would you say that was maybe 8? God, when the fuck was this, actually? Let me see what this is. Okay, for me, this... Okay, I was 7, alright? 7-year-old me, okay? 7-year-old me is sitting there thinking to himself, oh boy, wow, a Looney Tunes movie with Michael Jordan? I like basketball. I love basketball. I did. I actually love basketball. Back in, when I was a little boy, I actually liked sports. I was a T-ball player. I liked basketball. I was on the basketball team. And basketball team in middle school, actually. It was really fun. Oh, shit. You already fucking saw it. Anyway, fucking long story short. Yeah, little fucking, fucking like 7-year-old me sees this shit. Of course that shit's gonna be fucking hot. All right? 7-year-old me, innocent as fuck. That's like, wow, that's actually really attractive. Because, I mean, fucking, yeah, I get it. It's a rabbit, all right? But, like, how many people have the freaking saying,
hey, fucking Butterface, hey, hey.
All right? How about that then, all right? Butter rabbit. Shit. Another valid argument is the classic image of her spinning the basketball. Who doesn't like a good, talented person? And then the biggest problem now, though, that we've come to find is she has been replaced by a fraud. An imposter, if you will. Lo and behold, my friends, let us go to the bad guy. What the fuck is this? I don't like it just as much as you, but that's Lola Bunny as of today. What happened? Who knows? The fuck am I doing? Free? I don't know, man. Well, right now, we're just kind of chilling while we're trying to figure out how to get the reader add-on to work good. Kid-friendly? I mean, this is kid-friendly. I watched this when I was 7. How is this not kid-friendly? What's the problem here? Cry, please stop. What? What's the issue? This is a... What rating was Space Jam? This is literally from the movie. Space Jam. PG, alright? Not even 13, guys. This is a PG film with Michael Jordan. I was going to say his middle name, but I don't know it. What is his middle name? Alexa, what is Michael Jordan's middle name? Whoa, she's really quiet. Alexa, turn your volume up. I'm gonna say this a few more times so she gets the idea, okay? Alexa, turn your volume up. I'm gonna do this a few more times. Is there a way to do this like a shortcut? Can I just say volume max? Let me try that. Alexa, volume to max. Okay, we're gonna go fucking extreme here, okay, guys? Okay, ready? Alexa, what is Michael Jordan's middle name?
Michael Jordan's middle name is Jeffrey.
Thank you.
Of course.
Alexa, volume down. A little too loud. Alexa, volume down. I think that should be the sweet spot. Let's try this. Alexa. Hi.
Hiya.
Oh. What? It was weird. It was like a person. Like, it wasn't like Alexa. It was like a real person. It was like an FBI agent. That was my FBI agent. Oh my God. Who are you? What is your name? Who are you really, miss? My FBI agent just contacted me, guys. Holy fucking shit, it's recorded. This is evidence. Oh my God. Oh man. All right. You got me.
got me. I'm sorry. Alright, so anyway, can we get this reader add-on to work? This is because, oh, Alex is messaging me right now. Hey, random, but... Oh, okay, 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 okay. Hold on one second, one second. One second. Hang on, Alex is being cute. Sorry, Alex is being cute. So Alex just put his own emote, just randomly unprompted. I didn't ever like come to him asking about this, but he just randomly just prompted him. He was prompted just to randomly put his own emote, the Cry Y, up for tribute as the next tribute if we need a new emote for or a new slot for an emote. Because as you guys have noticed, we've lately come across some pretty fucking swaggy emotes. And, well, he says, this is exactly how the conversation went. His first interaction with me was at 11. He says, hey, random butt, you should totally get rid of the Cry YE to free up another emote slot. And he says, you've been getting great emotes lately, so I don't feel right that I'm taking one up of those slots, haha. And then it was just, and then I gushed at him because he's such a sweetie pie. And he's over there in Japan right now, so he's such a cute. Okay, I wished him a good day and I told him to eat some bomb ass udon. Cause I don't know about you guys, but I'd eat some bomb ass udon if I was in Japan land. That'd be my main prerogative for food intake, personally speaking. Alright, anyway, back to this. How can we actually customize this stuff, guys? Like, how do I customize the reader add-on? I can disable it or remove it. It doesn't really help me much. There's no options button. This is a fraud. Tell us about the ice cream date. I don't actually have the ice cream date. It was a fraud. I'm sorry, guys. I want to read. I know it's too bright. I'm trying to figure out how to customize it to lower the brightness and stuff, guys. Because it's too bright even for me. You know what I mean? And it says there's customizations and stuff, you know? Where's the color picker panel? Open reader view and hover your mouse near the bottom. Setting thing pops up and click on gear. Okay. Like, do I gotta, like, go all the way to the bottom of this? I don't see it. Maybe I need to restart my browser with this, though? Because I haven't actually restarted this yet, so... Uno momento, por favor, amigos, ¿cómo estás? Muy bien, gracias, ustedes. Oh, God. Oh, no, I killed the music! Oh, no, don't worry, guys. I will return with that momentarily. I'm just making sure I don't break everything. Please forgive. In the meantime, I will sing a song of my people.
Hi.
don't know what words I can say. The wind has a way to talk to me. Oh, it's back. All right, we're good. Props to anyone who actually knows what that was. I'm looking in chat. I'm waiting for it. I'm waiting for someone to call it out. Waiting for it. Someone will fucking say it. No one says it. There's not a proper, Yes! Rogue kind. You got me, man. Thank you for understanding me. For some reason, ever since I was a kid, I've always sung that song to myself every once in a while. I don't know why. It's just a fucking song that's always just been in my head. You wanna see the actual song? Because this is just, I know it's a reading stream technically, but realistically speaking, we can do anything because it's our stream. We don't have to follow the rules. It's our stream. So who fucking cares? So fuck it. Let me show you guys. Let's see here. So, Melfina's song. So, back in the day, I used to be a super weeb, right? I used to watch, you know. God, when I was really young, and my buddy Matt, he introduced me to anime with Tenchi Muyo, I think was actually one of the earliest ones, along with, you know, the typical Dragon Ball Z. One of the earlier ones as well. Actually, a little bit later on, actually, because realistically speaking, Alistar didn't come out until a bit. But, yeah, Alistar was one of them. And this was the song. It's probably super weeby and cheesy for Sheezy, Maneezy for TK Breezy, but that's okay. Because sometimes, fuck it, who cares, man? I was a baby boy and it was cute. Let's assume this is fine. Is this the actual vocal? No, this isn't the scene. Oh. Okay, that's really creepy. I don't like that. Let's go to the scene. Yeah, that was gonna give you guys nightmares. I'm sorry, guys. I didn't mean to do that. This might be safe. Maybe. Please be safe. Please be safe. This is a slideshow. This looks like a safe slideshow, maybe. No, I want the scene, though. I want the fucking scene. Where was that scene? Hold on, chat. I gotta actually search on YouTube. Unless someone else has it. Melfina's song scene. Man.
I don't know.
I mean, like, this is probably the best we're gonna get. Fuck it. Whatever. We're on this too long. All right. We're just gonna hit this shit. We're gonna hit play. You guys are gonna cringe at me for a bit, and then we're gonna pass on. Okay. Melfina.
What words I can say, the wind has a way to talk to me. Flowers sleep a silent lullaby.
This is a similar rhythm to your love song? Does it really? Maybe that's where the rhythm came from. Because, I mean, this is like a song that I've been singing in my head for, like, years, so... Let's see. Love, it is so far away. Oh, what can I say about love? Oh, love. Okay, let's see. I don't know what words... Oh my god, it is! It is! It's the same rhythm! Yo, we fucking went deep weep on this shit! The love song is a weep song! Revelation in the history of the lore of the freaking Cryotoic universe. Yeah, this changes so much shit. Oh no! From the fucking get-go! Oh, this is bad! This is real bad! Oh! Holy shit, this is great. Okay. Okay. All right. Wait. How long is the love song again? Because this is a minute 30. I know the love song went for a duration. If this matches up with the Melfina song, I'm going to be fucking, I'm gonna have a panic attack. Holy shit, dude, I'm freaking out right now. It's 202? Oh no, it's possible. Oh no, you could, oh no, that's fucking possible because there's an intro. Oh no. Guys, this is fucking too much for me, man. This is supposed to be a chill fucking... Bring me the fucking cozy vibes. Oh, shit. Fuck. Oh, that is something fucking else. Alright, so, Wow. I'm sorry, guys. This is a lot to process. This literally blew my mind. I had no idea. I had no idea. Oh, shit. Yo, So I know you guys want me to play them both at the same time. Could someone consider the fact that that's too much for me right now? Like, shit, man. Like, I need a buffer. Here, this is something that is also from my youth, okay? This is more of my tween-teen youth, though, okay? This is another anime youth thing. It's another song-related thing as well, okay? Okay, this will help us relax and calm, you know? We don't want to be freaking out here over this horrifying revelation anymore. Okay, so for those who don't know, way back in the day, I had a boyfriend who I thought was a girl at the time, but then it turned out it was a boy, and I was like, okay, I don't care, and we're gonna keep it going anyway. He was a weeb, and so I become the person that I'm more... I'm the kind of person, for those who don't know who I am as a person, as opposed to just, I'm being way too open and honest right now, I guess. But honestly, who cares? As a person behind the Cryotoic, I become very
you know, similar to the person I'm most hanging out with. And at the time, at that point, I was most hanging out with a fucking weeb. So I became a filthy fucking weeb, and this was one of those filthy fucking weeb things I fucking did. Also, I hang out with Angel all the time now, so that's why I'm wholesome as fuck now. Alright, here you go.
ニャンニャンニャンニャンニャンニハオニャンゴージャスデリシャスデカルチャーって CM知らない?
What? It's so good.
もうこんな時間?
It's so good. It's, guys, let's do it. Let's do it together, okay? Alright, we all know it. Now, once you see it once, you know how to do it, okay? Alright, we're all gonna do it. We're all gonna do it together, okay? Okay, get ready. Okay. Nyan 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 ni hano nyan. Gorgeous, delicious, delicious. Ah, fuck. Hang on, hang on. I fucked that one up. Let's try it again, chat.
Nyan nyan.
Nyan 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 ni hano nyan. Gorgeous, delicious, and decolucher. That was, you guys know the commercial, right? Guys, we should dub an anime. Oh, holy shit. That is genius. Guys, holy fucking shit. This is next tier shit right now. I have a lot of voice actor friends. I have Octo Pimp. I have Michaela Laws. I have fucking Sarah Ann Williams. Fuck. Aw, oh, dude. A fucking, like, a joke voiceover fucking anime dub? Oh my fucking shit. Like some, God, what was that? Ghost detective shit. Oh, that'd be so fucking fun. Because that's a thing that we could do. Like, alright, I get it. I bit off a bit more than I could chew with making an anime thing. When I wanted to make the Hansel anime, it was, like, a really good expression of, like, I wanted to express creativity at the time. But then I realized, wait a second, to make an anime, I'm gonna put this back on, to make an anime, that's also gonna cost thousands of dollars, and I did not want to do anything like a Kickstarter, because that makes people spend money, and I don't want to get to spend money. And I didn't feel like I was confident enough to want to go too hard into that, and at the time, I think I was being a little too brash with my decisions, but, here's the thing. With a fucking fan dub, we don't gotta make nothing. We just gotta fucking talk. It's easy as fuck. We just talk. We talking right now, motherfucker. Y'all probably talking right now. Oh, yeah, yeah. The storm was probably loud as hell. I'm sorry. Are we good now? Dub Sailor Moon? Oh, shit. That'd be sick. That'd be sick. Yo, hold up. What's a sailor? Yo, link me a Sailor Moon scene. We could do one right now. We could do a fucking fan dubbing right now, chat. Just a scene. We could just dub a scene. You know? Easy fucking peasy. What is a good scene? We cracked the code, baby. We could just do it. We, instead of just talking about shit, we just do it, you know? Fuck it. I'm tired of just talking about shit. I always talk about shit. Alright, what's some fucking weird scene? Alright, let's hope this isn't bad shit. I'm clicking this and believing in you. Okay, that's the storm. Calm the fuck down, alright. What is this here? Oh, keep in mind, this, the scene suggestions don't need to also be dubbed as well. They just need to have subtitles.
Hey, I'm home!
Oh, you're back. You're sure late getting home today.
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, by the way, I bumped into Umino earlier, and he said you got your test back already.
What?
He said he got a 95 on his.
Oh, really? Good for him. Darn you, Umino. I'm so gonna get you for this.
So, what did you get on your test, Usagi?
Oh, well, actually, the thing is,
Can I see it?
Okay.
Usagi!
Yeah?
Stop bringing home grades like this! Go outside and think
run!
But Mom!
I don't want to hear it!
Hey, you're in the way. So what huge mistake did Mom kick you out for this time? I sure wish I had a sister who wasn't a total loser.
Oh, how dare you talk to me like that! That's it! Sailor V kick!
Don't resort to violence, Usagi-chan. Need meatball head. Question chat. Alright, so right here. Okay, right here. So, there we go. Okay. Does anyone ever actually do that with their eye? Like, you know, they pull their eye down like that and then they stick out their tongue. Blah, blah, blah. Does anyone ever do that? In Japan, yeah. You used to? I don't think I've ever done that. I've only. It might have been a thing in the 90s, huh? Yeah, I guess that's true. Also, I like the fact that he has a see-through ruler, in case you haven't noticed, in his school supplies. That's actually a really cool thing, because I used to have a see-through one as well as a plastic. Dude, see-through plastic things were all the freaking rage in the freaking 90s. Ah, oh, dude. Hell yeah. Plastic. Wow. Dude, it's so fucking special. You'd be so surprised to see it again. I'm so glad we got away from the topic of playing those two songs at the same time, though. Goddamn, we're good at that. Alright, so anyway. Moving on. What? Alright, so let's do it, chat. Alright. Let's see how bad this is.
Hello?
Okay. This is gonna be weird, chat. All right, so let's see. How did this song go? Chat, this isn't gonna work. This isn't gonna work. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it, but it's not gonna work. It's not gonna work. Like, it's not going to. Like, it's not. It's just not. Like, we all need to just come to grips with this fact.
Love!
Shut up, me. Alright. I'm gonna definitely need to change some audio, because that's definitely louder than this.
I don't. So.
Alright, I think those volume levels are good.
So.
Okay. I'm just gonna play him. It's not gonna sound good, but you're gonna just gonna take what you can get, chat. Okay. Play yours first. Well, I've already gotten mine to the point where it. Let's just see.
About love. Love.
Flowers.
It's got more letters. Two of them are vowels. Two of them are really freaking weird. Because love, it starts with an L and ends with an E. And it has an O and V. It's better. Girl, I love someone, you. Please. It is so true. Because you know, girl, you make me smile.
Oh my God.
Oh, love. Maybe it's the greatest thing. It's like a diamond ring. On your finger when I'm close to you.
This is where I go off of my own thing here.
Box chocolate, girl.
Oh. It matched up, no, I'm so mad.
You're so dead. I don't know what I can do without you. Love, I love it too. How can you love, love? Because love is love. Oh, conundrum, what? Oh, I don't know what else. So I'm gonna end the song today, because love goes on today.
God damn it.
Love goes on today.
Guys, a ghost from my past just became a nightmare. The fuck, man? Soothing music.
Too loud!
Storms. Yo, this thunderstorm. Yo, I'm not sure about this thunderstorm aesthetic. It was chill as fuck at first, but now this thunderstorm's getting a little intense, man. Yo. Can this thunderstorm chill the fuck out? Jesus. Yo, what the fuck type of year is this storm taking place in? I'm offended. Face your fears? Oh shit, I guess this is supposed to be a spooky stream. No crime, I'm about to die in a thunderstorm. Get used to it. Fuck, I mean, I do live in Florida, so I guess I should. I did have to evacuate the other year. Was it last year? I don't remember anymore. Kind of normal with you, my man. I remember LimeWire. Your past always comes back to bite you. Do you remember LimeWire or LimeLight? You're cute. I like you. I get you, though, man. Thanks, man. Oh, shit. Is it a spooky story? I mean, we could get some spookers. We got some no sleeps right now, but I'm not sure what we got just yet. Oh shit, thank you, Big Mackers. Also, Ace Failure. For 200 bits has just bought my first set of bits. Oh, nice, dog. Well, I hope you spend them wisely and don't spend them all on one streamer. You should spend them on some lower streamers who have, like, you know, 20 viewers or something. Dude, seriously. You want to make someone's fucking day? You want to make someone's day and you got, like, $2? Go find a streamer with, like, 2 viewers. And they got bits enabled. And they look sad. Give them $2. They're gonna be so fucking happy. I've done that shit so many times. Oh shit, it's super fun. Oh. Alright, listen. Make another music video with Dave. I can't pressure the man to make music videos. That motherfucker's making goddamn PewDiePie roast videos on T-Series. You don't wanna make a goddamn music video with me no more. Shit. I'm doing great. I'm having a good day, man. I'm a budget Mr. Beast. How does Mr. Beast do? I know of Mr. Beast, but I've never actually watched Mr. Beast. Can I like a very derpy Sailor Moon animation? I mean, I love Sailor Moon animation, so yeah. Craig it off by throwing money at the port. That is not a fact. Uh-oh, don't fall down the hole. Which hole? The anime hole? There's a lot of holes to fall down there. Read more Junji Ito with Russ pulls. And if Russ is here. You know what? No. Alright, listen. Alright, you know what? I do want to do a cooperating stream with Russ in the future now that you mentioned that, because that sounds really fun. We had a great time when we did that. But I really like the atmosphere we got right now, and I don't want to hinder that potentially. Just because when you get a second person in there, I can't be as intimate with chat anymore. You know what I mean? And then I feel like, you know, it's not the same atmosphere. No offense to Russ, of course. But I do want to do that now that you guys mentioned it. That does sound like a fun idea. But you guys get me? You feel me, dog? Because I always feel bad when I do group streams because I can never feel like I can talk to chat. I always, you know, I don't know. Bums me out. You know what I mean? Frick. What were we doing again? We never got Reader to actually properly work. I know that. I don't know why. It seems like it'd be so simple. People were saying like a little thing pops up. Oh, wait. I never actually tested it after I restarted my browser. That's right. So let's see here. They said something would pop up. Wait. Oh! Ah! Chat! Look! New tech! Frick yeah, we're in this! Alright, we finally have hit it. Oh my, we just had to restart our browser the whole time, guys. It was, this stream's been going on for an hour, but honestly, I've been having a great time, and hopefully you have as well. Font? What font should we use, chat? It just looks like I can just type a font. Yeah, I can just type a font in. That's a first. I'm not reading Comic Sans. Alright, size. What's a good size that would be nice and legible to read that would not be straining on the eyes for a person that has, what is my prescription for eyes? For those who know eye prescription, I have it right here, I think anyway, unless I've chucked it. No, it's right here. Alright, chat. For those who know eye prescriptions, my prescription is, I still don't fully know what the difference is between OD and OS. I'm guessing, like, one is left eye, one's right eye. But, it is 8.S. Why do I do that? Okay. That's another thing I want to talk about. I'm going to make a note of this, actually, about talking about this with you guys, because this is like more of like a brain question. Okay. Anyway, back to where I was at. So the OD is 8.6, and the OS is 8.4. But the SPH on the OD is -4, and the OS is -4.50. OS is left eye, OS, OD is right eye. Okay, that's what I figured. Yeah, so my right eye is 8.4, -4.50. It's not too bad. I mean, there are people with way worse vision, that's true. I mean, have you seen Roz from Sabrina? Sorry. My bad. So anyway, about that size of fun, guys. Who's my favorite Game of Thrones character? That's a good question. Do 69 for the meme, but probably tune it down. Alright, we'll do 69 for now. Just to see what we get for now. What's my favorite Game of Thrones character? I know the answer, but I need to think just to make sure I don't mistaken. Okay, yes, I have the answer. I will never not have this answer. But I have a... Well, yeah, okay. So for right now, I'm going to pull up a picture, okay? I actually talked about this today on Dodger's stream earlier. I don't know if I was streaming at the point of them, because I was, in case you were curious, earlier in the day I streamed with Dodger and Jesse and G-Mart. We did some World War Z, and before my stream started, we did a round, and we had a great time, actually. A really, really fun time. If you want, go check Dodger's VOD of her stream today. I'd say that was probably one of the better VODs that, I've partaken in. If, at least for the first few hours, if you want. You don't have to, it's just a suggestion, and it would also help out a good friend of mine, Dodger, because she's a great gal. She had a baby recently, Clark. She's a beautiful baby. So the character, my favorite character personally speaking, is this rather handsome gentleman. I feel like a lot of people could understand why he is my favorite. I mean, a lot of people also were probably like, oh, right, by the way, because of reasons. But, you know, fair. However, if you would like my current two favorite characters, I have a pairing that I like, okay? Hold on. Hold on, chat. Give me a moment to gather my things, okay? Okay. Hold on. Hold the line, chat. I'm sorry. I'm taking a little bit of time here because I'm apparently really bad at Googling these days. And I don't want to show it yet because it'd be spoiling. Actually, no, it'd make my life easier just to hide my screen really quick and pull it over to this screen. Sorry. Hi, how you guys doing? I know you're waiting forever. I'm a piece of crap streamer, but... have you kissed your dog today on the lips? Or at least the top of its head? Consider it. It might make you or them feel happy. One or the other. Gorge. Okay, hold the phone. I keep saying that. I repeat words often, chat. In case you are also unaware, I'm the kind of person who, I talk before I think, which can lead to problems. But, hopefully, I don't freaking say anything too stupid when I'm talking. And sometimes when I talk before I think, I can repeat myself at times. We get it, you're a free. Alright, listen here, you shady son of a bitch. Well, that's not what I want. You know, it says it's a giant image, but it sure ain't. You know, that'll do. Okay. Okay, hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on. I'm almost done, guys. Alright. Okay. Alright. My... No! God damn it! What am I... So, oh, hey Scott, you're not cozy anymore? I'm sorry, your stress is gone now, suddenly. Okay. Is that? Okay, it's back. Okay. Probably been stuck out in this rain for how long now? Alright, I'm sorry. Here, come back in, guys. Come back in. So, my favorite is Jamie, Brienne, and Tormund's love triangle. Because, you know, it's gonna be super. Because he's got a crush on Brienne, and Brienne's got a crush on Jamie, and Jamie's just like, I respect you, Brienne. I think it's super cute. Like, I fuck my sister. I am a knight now. Wait, I am a wildling, and I locked the fort. Oh, hello. Oh, thank you, probably. Appreciate that very much. And distracted the server for 3.50. Hey, Cry, have you ever read Tales from the Gas Station? It's an amazing no sleep series. Now shut up and take my money. No, I have not. It's a great idea now. I kind of want to check it out. Why is this storm not nearly as loud as it was last time? That's better. Cry, you seem to have an affection for incest and incestuous people. Well, I am in Florida. It's considered the South. I suppose you could say it, well. I don't know where that was. I was gonna make a joke, but now it just sounds creepy. Damn it. I'm sorry, guys. That was a fail. Anyway. Back to customizing this ship. Let's go to default there. Wait, I guess. Default, too. Color. Alright, this is where we want to really make sure. What is the optimal colors for reading comfort? I need to not meme this, guys. We're not memeing this. What's up, Zero? Hi. I'm sorry, I have to say Zero Doxy because I know Zero as well. So if I say Zero Doxy, it's just Zero. When you're Zero Doxy, when Zero is around, he might get confused. Like, he's not around right now. But, like, if he was, you know what I mean? Red is really nice on your eyes. I don't know if I agree with that. We'll call you Doxy anyway. Oh, sick nasty. Alright, can I get, green is best, like, real talk? Like, bird. Okay, chat, what I need from you guys is the red, the green, and the blue palette for the text and the background, and I don't know what the anchor color is. I'm guessing that is the URL colors. Don't care about the URL color then. Just for the color and the background. You're asking a lot of chat, I believe. Alright? Chris Fox, I believe. I believe. Sorry. Question, this is a cave, right? Hello, and welcome to me in a cave. No? Oh shit, is it broken? Oh, it's me in a cave? Oh, okay, cool, cool. Dark gray background. Background, damn it. Let's see here. Okay, hold on a second. Chris Fox, I need you. I trust you. I trust you, you crazy son of a bitch. Can you pick one of those, one of the selections from chat? Because you're really good at reading chat. Or one of you that are good with colors. Pick one of those and just let me know in the comments below. Yeah, it's Broken Cry and it's Lonesome. Wait, it's broken? Is it really broken? Hold on a second, chat. Hang on. Hello. Oh. Hey. Yo, no. Wait, this isn't a... I don't know what this is. What is this? Wait. Oh. Okay. Some weird shit. It's not really a cave, though.
Then there's this one. Yo, what if we read a story like this? What the fuck? Shit, hang on, we're really gonna get these colors. Okay, I'm bad at colors, I picked the first one I read. Okay, I believe.
Sorry, I'll turn it off. Okay. It's back to black, right? I know. I put it in the wrong color. This is the background color, I believe. So now the question is it black now on this? Do we want that? Is that a thing we would like to see on our thing today? Let's see. For real, Cry, are you using UX2 still? And if so, what setting was that? No, I'm using GoXLR nowadays, my dude. How you doing, frickin' Fracker? I want to give you a pat on the head. I can't, but yes, I can. There you go, bud. That's for you. All right, let's see if this worked. All right. Yo, I'm okay, maybe I should unzoom. Oh, yeah, I had the size set to 69 as well. It looks like it's a bit too big. Should definitely change that. Oh yeah, a little too big. 69 for the meme was a bit much. Also, what's an actual font we should be using, chat? Because, fuck if I know. We're not using Comic Sans, Bellbeat. Ariel's good. Can't go wrong with Ariel. Is it Ariel or Ariel? It's Ariel, right? I'd say, what, like 45 for this? And then for the link, you know, hold on a second. We want a good link color, right? Let's pick something like that. Because it'll look good. It'll look so good. Just check your shit. Box width, that's probably everything else is fine. All right, chat. Futura? You know what? That sounds sick as fuck. I want to see what that looks like. Assuming it even exists. Alright, refresh. Let's see. It looks still too big to me. Actually, no, this looks fine. This is really good, actually. Yeah, this is sick. But we should probably pick a different font, though. This is too plain and lame. That's not Futura? Alright. But I do like that size of font, though. So, Pap... Chat... That... I mean, like... Yeah. What? Where the hell is my... Can you at least tell me what fonts I have available, like in a drop-down? You're just telling me to type in shit. Wait, there's a click here. Oh, there's a click's always there. No, there's nothing here I can do. Mono type course. Okay. It should refresh it each time, just to make sure. I don't think that changed it or did it. I'm not sure. Probably not. Looks the same, I think. Alright, which font would actually probably exist on the Windows default system, guys? Just to make sure. I don't think I broke it. It's just that I think this program just doesn't have those fonts. Unless maybe I broke it by having two of those things open. So maybe if I refresh it now... Maybe that'll work. Who knows? I mean, the biggest test we could do to see if it's still working is just change the size of the font to see if it'll change, but... I mean, this looks like, you know... A thing, you know what I mean? What version? Windows 10. Yeah, so yeah, what we could easily do is just set this to 69 again real quick, just to see. Just to test. Man, I'm totally into these chill streams, what the fuck? Alright, so now we'll see. Yeah, it's totally working. Okay. Georgia font? That's a classic. Isn't it just called Georgia? Well, I mean, I know you meant that, but I mean, I'm talking to myself, essentially. You know what I mean. What? This is working. This is good. This is new, right? Georgia's... Yeah, right? Or am I wrong? Yeah? Okay. I like this. This is fine. Like, it's still normal, but it's better than what we had. Georgia's got class? Yeah, exactly, right? Like, I wouldn't mind a look at this. I don't even know if this is a good thing. It was just the top of the past month, by the way. So I have no freaking clue. Also, I don't even know if you guys... I'm assuming you guys would want to read... But for the record, here's the problem with reading. I'm just gonna like just spell it out for you. If you can read, like, say for example, I got all this here, right? If you can read all this too while I'm doing my shit, I'm probably gonna be at like here, and you're gonna be at here, and you're gonna be like fucking irritated at how slow I take, because this has happened before. You guys are gonna say no, we wouldn't, but I know humans. You guys would, because I'm a slow reader, and the humans who read in their brains, who read ahead, are gonna be like, don't like that son of a bitch. So I could either have this screen or this screen, which is just a chill little, you know, nice little screen. Whichever one. I mean, this one's just cozy, and I'll make sure to read audibly so you won't miss shit. So, yeah, we'll just do this screen. This is mostly just for me so I can read better now. Alright, that's fine. But, this is... We'll do that screen when we pick something. For now, we still gotta pick something, chat. So, someone mentioned the gas station... the Tales from the Gas Station. Let me search that off stream, or not off stream, but off monitor here. I don't know what's in my fucking search history on Reddit, just for the record. Gas Station. Wait, Tales from the Gas. Like, There we go. What NSFW things have you been searching? Well, you see, have you heard of Ricardo? We stand Ricardo in here? Oh, we definitely do. You know what, chat? I think it's time. We need a little... We need a little something. Nope. Where you at? Where the fuck you at? Wait! I'll get the actual video for you. We'll get it better. I was just going on Spotify. But, hold up. I'm trying to remember which one it was, but I'm just gonna assume this is probably gonna... on chat. You know what? It's really hard to find a good meme these days. You know? Like, if there's just so many imposter memes out there. It's like, which one's the original memer? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Like, wow. That's a lot. We found... Aw, shit. Hold on a second. You know what? This is probably fine. No. Damn it. Hold on, chat. Why is this so hard? This is fine. Let's assume this is fine.
Cause you got that. 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 Like you.
Yeah, so Ricardo is fucking the fucking man. That's the kind of shit I'm into. Anyway, back to this hot fucking James here. What were we doing again? Oh, we were gonna look for a thing now. I'm banned? No. Twitch is fine with Ricardo, trust me. Ricardo should pretty much be a Twitch staff member at this point. Come on. He's close with everybody. They're friends. Alright, so anyway, the gas station. I pulled it up, didn't I? Was that another tab? Oh, it was this tab. Alright, I got this thing here. This was suggested by Distracted Disturber. We can give it a shot. Maybe. Let me go get some water first, because I've been actually sitting here for an hour and a half, and I haven't actually done any reading yet. An hour and a half of a reading stream where the reading has not happened sounds like a Crytoic stream. Tumeezies. Wow. So let me go grab some water. I'll be right back, chat. I'll just leave you with the sounds of this fucking lovely shit. I'll be right back. I'm not even gonna put a song on, so it'll be minutes. I'm just gonna leave, grab water, so I'm more obligated to return, because I know you are not entertained in the slightest other than this beautiful... I'm taking off my pants. One second, actually. A little warm. This beautiful storm, though. Babs, you wanna see it? You wanna see it? Here. Here, you can look at that while I'm gone. I'll be right back, okay? Right back.
God, are you guys okay out there? Looks like it's getting a little, wet, windy. I brought in the lawn furniture. Is Ralphie in? Did we bring him inside? Did you guys get him? I don't see him anywhere yet. I'm a little worried. I haven't seen Ralphie since this morning, you know? So, you know, I got a little concerned. But I'm sure he's just sleeping in the garage or something right now. Right? Right. Right. Oh boy. Oh wow. Well, anyway, let's move on. Okay. Anyway, so let's try Tales from the Gas Station if you guys are down. Ralphie's been dead for 4 years, Cry. You should need to let it go. Fuck! You know, actually, for those who don't know, there's some deep lore involved with the name Ralphie. Thank you, Stom Schwarz. There's some deep lore with the name Ralphie. Way back in the early days, Russ and I collaborated on the Frictional Games Forum for a 24-hour custom story, Amnesia custom story collaboration project with other custom story creators. I'm gonna turn that down a bit because the storm's picking up. But yeah, we collaborated. We made the project. We were the head people behind it, and we made a project. And our plot was going through the original, you know, getting to the first hub of Amnesia by rewriting the we rewrote the beginning of Amnesia until you get to the beginning of the hub, or the first hub area where it's like, you know, the big place that you can get to, like the library and the cistern, I think it was. But turn the storm down. Your mom says it's loud. Dude, listen, your mom needs to relax, okay? Anyway, long story short, the whole plot was our Ralphie, was our dog, and our dog, was kidnapped. That was essentially, the whole thing. That was the plot. Sorry. That's the long and short of it. But... you can probably find that somewhere. Actually, hold on, let me... 24-hour... Yeah, right here. Here we go, chat. This is it. 2011. Russ Money and Cryotic gave a public call for the bravery... With bravery, cunning... Oh, wow, this is fucking 2011, alright. Russ Money and Cryotic gave a public call to those with bravery, cunning, intelligence, and free time to create an Amnesia map within the time span of 24 hours. Those who were amazing enough to answer the call brought forth their awesome modding skills to produce this, the 24-hour Amnesia compilation. The story? You take control of Daniel, who wakes up with a terrible hangover, very little memory of the prior night, and find out that your best friend, a puppy named Ralphie, is missing. Search for him, and hopefully he's just fine. See what you have what it takes to find your beloved Ralphie. See? That was it. Cool. Alright, chat. Let's do this thing. Going in. By the way, thank you, Endless Nethers, Dakunido, Red Scarf, Divide by Zero, Chio Abra, I'm sorry, Chio Ibra, Princess CC Meows, Toasty Guy, Maker, how's it going? You probably remember me as one of your old subscribers, Black Doom. I do remember that name, actually. Yeah, gone for a new makeover, a new name. Anyway, I came to watch stream after finishing my own Mortal Kombat 11 story stream. Hopefully you had a good time, my guy. Appreciate it. Also, Cypher DC. And probably Cinny again. Thank you. Is it time to read yet? It is now time to read, chat. Finally. Chat question. Is this background... I feel like it's too intense.
It's gotta, this is a gas station thing. I need an atmosphere of like a late night gas station. You know what I mean? That's what I want. This story is about the Gas Station Chronicles. It's good? No. No. You're giving up too fast. This is exactly how, like, 80% of the videos that ended up not getting recorded happened, because I was too much of a fucking perfectionist and I needed to get everything just fucking right, and it took hours and hours, and by the flippin' time I realized I just had to restart the goddamn computer to fix the performance problems, I was too flippin' tired to have any energy to do any commentary. Sorry. That was my life for years, guys. Like, oh boy. All right. So anyway. Flip and read. Hey, chat, listen. Here's the thing, guys. I need you guys to relax. I need you guys to tone it down. Put the guns away. What does the title of the stream say? Cry's Cozy Corner. This is not point guns at Cry and make him do things, Corner. This is, we're cozy and we're chilling over here. You know, let's calm down. Let's relax, okay? Put the guns away. We're here to chill. What was that statement here? This is not Cry's ADD Corner focus, Dad. You know what? Actually, it is. Thank you, probably, Cindy. This is Cry's ADD Corner because this is Cry's Cozy Corner. And Cry actually encompasses ADD, which right there in the title, it says ADD Corner, you dumb bitch. Thank you anyway, though. You did this yourself. You played Ricardo, was chill before that. That's true, actually. I did play Ricardo. That is true. I'm sorry, Vibe Pizza. That was a bit aggressive. I love you. Would you like me to, what could I possibly do? Here. I'll do one last thing that I wanted to talk about before we go to reading, because this was something I did want to talk about, okay? So this is the last thing, because this is actually something that actually means something to me, okay? I promise. This is something I've been wanting to talk about, but I usually forget because of my bad memory. So, ever since I was a kid, I've always had the linking between the letter R and the number 5, and the letter S and the number 6. And I found that weird, because they were also, you know, the next in line in numbers and an alphabet. Is there a reason for that? Or is that just my brain being weird? Can you see it? I mean, like, I don't know why. Maybe it's just how they look. I think it's just your brain. It might just be. I was just wondering if that was like a normal human thing to think, or just like a unique human thing. That's fair. You see it? I mean, like, here. So you guys, like, freaking, you know, capital R, 5, S, 6, you know what I mean? Like, kind of similar, I guess, to a stupid kid. I don't know. That's where my brain went with it, though. I taste words, I feel you. That's right! There are a lot of people who do a lot of weird things with their brains when it comes to, like, you know, their senses. It's crazy what brains do, man. So, yo, that's, yeah, Summer smells pics. Yo, if you send Summer a dick pic, she'll smell your cheese. Wow, that was good. Okay, all right. Ugh. Oh, wow. Oh. Okay, anyway, you guys wanna... Oh, man. Oh, jeez. One second here.
Hang on. One second. I'm being told to calm down.
Hey, Cry, do you have a form of synesthesia? Because I have a form where I can see colors when I hear things, so maybe look into it. Also, I'm enjoying the stream. Thank you, Cry Y and Cry Comfy.
One second, I'm sorry. Hey, Cry, do you have a form of synesthesia? Because I have a form where I can see colors and hear things. So maybe look into it. Also, I'm enjoying the stream. Thank you. Thanks, man. I don't have synesthesia, but I definitely have seen stuff like that before. Like, I've watched a lot of videos on YouTube and stuff like that. I'm sorry, I just, like, totally got distracted on Discord. My bad. Okay.
Well, now you fucked up!
Jesus, Deggy.
I'm curious, what would Chia do with a pick of a pretty flower?
Probably smell the flower, I don't know. I mean, realistically speaking, can't see alerts? Well, I mean, realistically, wait, you can't see alerts? You should be able to see alerts. That? I don't know, I won't be able to see those alerts. But to my understanding with how that whole thing works, she doesn't actually smell like what she sees. It's just like she smells like something random. But yeah. But you guys can't see him though. That's weird. I don't know why. Cry, it's Chad. Haven't heard a story from you in a while, man. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're doing well. Read to me so I know you're not dead. I'm sorry, Boo. Got you. Alrighty. So, let's go ahead and try. Actually, you know what? Hang on. Let me go ahead and put on a creepy song to set the mood. So, then we can, like, you know, get a nice buffer into the proper setting.
Because we gotta get into the mindset now of creepy stuff setting, okay? Because I'm not creepily set right now. I'm not creepified. What is a nice spooky song setting here?
Well, now you fucked up!
Guys. Sorry the lords aren't showing. Thank you very much, probably Cinny and Daggyzen, both of you very much. That's very sweet of you guys. Thank you. Alright, chat. We're gonna go with the classic. This is Never Let Anyone Down Ever. And I'll be right back, okay? Good luck.
Scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek. We're so sorry, skeletons, you're so misunderstood. You only want to socialize,
but I don't think we should.
Cause spooky, scary skeletons shout startling, trilly screams. They'll sneak from their sarcophagus and just won't let you be. Scary skeleton.
Sorry.
You could tell me Cry sang backup vocals for the song and I'd fucking believe you? Man, that'd be weird. Imagine if I sang backup vocals for that song, or any vocals for that song at all. That'd be crazy, right? Wow. Oh, wow. Oh, jeez. Oh, wow. Anyway, hey guys, sorry about that. Hopefully it should be all good now. Y'all ready to get some spooky on? Hopefully y'all are properly scared now. Finally reading? Yes. So, let's get nice and cozy, everyone. Let's relax. Daggies, by the way. You crazy son of a bitch. For 5,000 bits during that. God is love. Love by money. Feel my love deep inside you, boo. Now take us away on a spooky voice adventure. That sounds fucking great to me, man. Thank you very much, dude. As well as Commander Walrus, Calboyo, Storms of Shadow, Barugi, Roseco, and Shockbeats. And Threeternity. Thank you, guys. Alright, 2 hours later. Let the reading finally happen. I guess. Check DMs when you can. That's spicy. That's real good. I like that. Also, let's see. Oh, there we go. That's why it's not showing. Look at that. Isn't that just precious? I love it. Thank you so very much, you. That was very nice of you to draw that. You know why? Because you didn't have to do it. You did it because you wanted to do it. And that's fucking dope. Thank you. You. We're gonna read? Okay. Let's read, guys. No, wait. We had to get the atmosphere. That was right. Hold on. We were gonna get... Hold on, this will be really easy. I'm just gonna type it, okay? I'm just gonna type it. Late night parking lot atmosphere. It's gonna probably pop up immediately. Rain in parking garage. Not sure about that one. Night rain on car. That one doesn't sound bad. Like, we could be, like, in, you know, a car. That, let's see how that sounds. Huh? And it's a gas station thing, so it makes sense. A little intense, though. I'm gonna have to lower it a bit. But that's pretty good, yeah? We can work with that? Okay. Good, good, good. Okay, chat. Question. The biggest question of all. Is the volume good? That's the last thing I need, and then I'm ready. Yes, volume is great. Perfect. Okay. Wonderful. Now, finally! Let's get cozy. Tales from the Gas Chamber. Chapter 1. At the edge of our town, there's a shitty gas station that's open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you were to go inside, you'd see row after row of off-brand chips, cookies, potted meats, and pickled curiosities. Expiration dates suspiciously missing from the canned goods, like they were filed off years ago in some misguided attempt to control inventory turnover. I read a little too long that time, I'm sorry. A faded wet floor sign from way back covers a large crack in the foundation by the cooler where layers of sticky spill-off have formed a miniature tar pit, preserving countless insect corpses and occasional small rodents. Nobody ever complains about the aesthetic,
By some providence, bordering on the supernatural, the health inspectors repeatedly signed off on the business, always kindly ignoring the faint smell of some kind of mysterious chemical cocktail that is the defining characteristic of the establishment. More noticeable than the steady mechanical hum of the frozen drink machine that was installed in the 70s and everyone serviced. More than distracting than the... Wait, I'm sorry. I fucked that up. Rain is loud? Okay. I lowered it just a smidge. That good now? Okay. Now, where were we? Still a little loud? Really? Okay. I want people to say perfect, guys. I see a few perfects, but I want everyone to be happy, okay? If y'all aren't happy, then we have a problem here. Good now? Okay. Alright, everyone's happy. Okay. I'm just gonna start over from this paragraph, just so we can all get back into the mode and be reintroduced into the world of this gas station thing. I don't know what this is. Let me take a sip of water. Alright. Nobody ever complains about the aesthetic. By some providence bordering on the supernatural, the health inspector has repeatedly signed off on the business, always kindly ignoring the faint smell of some kind of mysterious chemical cocktail that is the defining characteristic of the establishment. More noticeable than the steady mechanical hum of the frozen drink machine that was installed in the 70s and never once serviced. More distracting than the random pockets of cold and warm air that seem to follow you around. And more annoying than the family of mutated raccoons that lives in the crawl space behind the grease trap. You think they're mutated anyway, at the very least. But they must be inbred to the point of genetic deformity or mental retardation. The Alpha, a muscular 3-foot-tall son of a bitch named Rocco, has been spotted multiple times chewing on people's tires, has run over at least twice, and keeps coming back. That lingering smell, a sweet combination of honeysuckle, ammonia, and a vomit, has never been positively identified. But the prevalent theory is that it's coming from underground, wafting up through the thin fissures in the concrete that grow up and spread with each year of architectural settling. It's strongest right after the rain, and pungent to the point of tear-inducing you to get too close to the storm drains where even Rocco and his clan refuse to tread. If you were to go inside, you might also see the bathroom cowboy. He's sort of an urban legend around here, is only appearing when you're alone and unsuspecting. What makes him truly legendary are the stories people telling after an alleged encounter. The accounts run the gamut of pretty weird to impossibly bizarre. Like the guy last month who went for a pee but changed his mind when he saw him standing next to the urinal, wearing a duster, bandana, boots, and chaps, handing out balloon animals. Or a couple weeks later when another customer stepped into the same bathroom to see a man wearing nothing but a cowboy hat, boxers, and boots, and spurs, literally grinding an axe on an old-fashioned sharpening stone wheel. When he answered, the cowboy stopped what he was doing, looked up with a smile on the tip of his hat, and said, "Come on, man. Come on with it." If you should be lucky enough to see the cowboy that may or may not haunt the bathroom, don't worry. He's harmless. And in fact, usually quite polite. Honestly, he doesn't seem so bad. Especially compared to some of the other things going on in that place. When you go inside, you might instantly get a toothache. That's a strangely common phenomenon that nobody really understands. It should go away on its own after a couple of hours. If you go inside, you will almost definitely see me sitting behind the counter. Because I'm the only full-time employee, and I'm almost always here. You may catch me reading a book because, for some reason, the internet doesn't work way out here, and cell phone service is dicey on good days and non-existent on most. If you need to make a call, you can leave and go up the hill a ways, preferably back towards town, because the other way will take you into the woods, and you don't even want to go into all the reasons why that's not a good idea. Or you can pay me 25 cents a minute and use the store's landline. That arrangement was cooked up by the owners, and I have to actually enforce it because they do check the phone records, so I'm sorry about that. While you're here, don't be offended if I don't strike up a conversation, because if I'm being completely honest, I don't always know for sure if everyone who comes through those doors is real or not, and if I had to acknowledge everyone in that place that could be an actual person, I might lose my mind. And we don't need any more of that going around on here. I guess that the point I'm trying to make is this. Weird things happen to me working at this shitty gas station at the edge of town. I wish I could tell you the weirdest thing that's ever happened there, but I doubt I could ever decide. There's just too many. I've seen a total of 4 coffins inside the store on 3 different occasions. I met at least a dozen people wandering back into town from the woods, claiming that they had escaped aliens or government conspirators or the like, and they had no money but needed to make a call, but shit, my first flub. Damn it, I was going so good. Shit. I never normally do that good. Fuck. I'm drinking water now. Okay. Sorry. Back to this. Claiming they had escaped aliens and... Oh, wait, I was not talking in my Reese voice. I'm talking in my chill voice. No, we gotta go. We're in chillin'. We gotta go to Reed chillin'. Down. Down. Relax. My Reese voice is me fully relaxed. You know what I mean? It's where you just go, like, you sink into yourself. Ugh. You just... It's pretty much the comfy. I'm leaning back and I'm just chill. It's so nice. Full relaxation. Claiming they had escaped aliens and government conspirators alike, and they had no money but needed to make a call, and could I please just let them use our store phone before they find them again? But rules are rules, and I'm not inclined to lose my job just because you didn't escape captivity with a little pocket change. And then, of course, there was Farmer Brown. Yeah, that's his real name. He got mad at us and complained about the bulk feed we'd been ordering for him. He insisted something was wrong with the product because, as he put it, all of his animals suddenly had human faces. We settled with him by charging a significant discount on his next couple purchases. He stopped coming in not long after, and they found what was left of his body inside a bedroom at his farmhouse that had been locked from the inside. As far as I know, they still haven't figured that one out. Anyway, I guess I can come back and tell you a story or two, but first I need to get ready for work. And then there's a shit ton of choices, it looks like. Oh boy. Alright. Fancy. Cool, cool, cool. Neato. Let me go ahead and bam. Okay. So we shouldn't have any more alerts popping up. We want to have full atmosphere. Alright. So I guess we'll just go to part 2. See how it goes. Give it a shot. Give it a whirl. Whether it's good, whether it's bad, I don't know. But I like the setup so far. It's interesting. Choices? It's not really choices. It was more just like part 2, part 3, part 4, but it was all linked on the first one. It wasn't really choices. I just went to part 2. Can you have a link? Oh, yeah. Did we not have a link for it already? Here we go. Here's the actual store if you guys would like to go there. That's the one we just read. And the one we're doing right now is this. Okay. I if you do read along, you will notice that I don't actually always say exactly what they say. I'm kind of like freeform going about it. It's weird. I don't know. Whatever. That's fine. Oh, okay. As long as I don't get yelled at for, like, changing how stuff is said, because sometimes people yell at me. I'm like, I'm sorry, I just took some creative liberties with their work. I'm sorry. It just sounded better coming out of my lips that way, because I'm, like, I have a different cadence than how you have a cadence. Jeez. Sorry. Anyway, let's resume. Chapter 2. A-dub that shit? Oh my god, dude. We totally need to dub an anime. Oh my god. At least the scene, guys. We gotta do it. But first, we read. At the edge of our town, there's a shitty gas station that's open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and sometimes longer. If you were to go inside, you would probably see the tired cashier sitting behind the front desk, doing his best to mind his own business. He's real. You may also see someone else. You may also see something else. If you're curious about the reality of anyone or anything, including yourself, inside that small ammonia-scented flickering fluorescent collection of off-brand junk food, dirt, four walls, and a roof, may I recommend that you follow the cashier's lead and mind your own business? I like that sass. I've been working at the gas station almost non-stop since I graduated high school, and at this point, I doubt I could quit if I wanted to. Not long ago, a doctor recommended that I start keeping a journal, and after some consideration, I decided I might as well give it a shot. It's not like any of the traditional treatments are having any effect. But enough about me. Let's get back to the interesting thing. Gas station. I spent a decent portion of my shift at the... Try that again. I spent a decent portion of my shift last night trying to decide how to begin this journal. Where can I start that wouldn't make any sense at all? How do I explain the gas station to someone who hasn't experienced it? I've tried telling some of my stories before, so I know what to expect. But people don't really believe it. Or people don't want to believe it. I still remember the difficulty I had last year when I had to call the sheriff station and explain to the new girl that half of a pig had broken into the store and was running amok, breaking things and screaming with the voice of an old woman. Yes, I meant half of a pig. Yes, a pig. The front half? No, it's not a joke. I'm at the gas station. What do you mean, which gas station? Is this your first day or something? Oh, it is. Oh, shit. In that case, can I please talk to someone else? She finally put me through to Tom. He's the deputy that drew the short straw of all those years ago and ended up on the official gas station duty. That was back before his hair turned all white. He's been in enough times now that all I have to say when he picks up the line is, it's half a pig, it won't stop screaming and I can't catch it. And then he grunts, mutters something about that being pretty friggin' weird, and then he drives out to help me catch it. Tom's a good guy. I asked around, but nobody knew where the pig came from. Farmer Brown, who was still alive at the town, came down to take a look and provide his expert opinion. According to Farmer, the pig had somehow been chopped down the middle, but miraculously none of the important organs were hit. Nothing supernatural about it, just really unusual. It stayed at the local elementary school as a kind of mascot for the summer before a scientist and his team from somewhere up north offered a school $1,000 to let them take it. For science, I suppose. I don't mean to ramble, but my point is that it's hard to believe some of the stories if you haven't been inside the gas station at least once. Maybe you have. We're the only gas station for miles. We're close enough to some big crossroads. If you ever been out driving in an unfamiliar part of the country, find yourself lost, it's not impossible that you could have found yourself in my doors, looking to top off your gas and ask for directions. If you have a strange memory of a weird place that somehow doesn't seem to fit, then there's a chance that we actually have met. It was late into my overnight shift when I decided to just start writing. I took notes about what was happening, jotted down a few of my stranger memories, but consciously decided to leave out those stories that were so unbelievable that I won't even waste people's time with them. I call those the try and forget stories. I was trying to write it all down on a book of received paper when Carlos interrupted me. Carlos is one of the part-timers at the gas station. We have a pretty long list of part-timers employees here. The owners like to hire transients, drifters, hitchhikers, passerby, and runaways looking for work for a few days. I try not to get to know the part-timers. They come and go after a few days or sometimes a few weeks, really long enough to form any kind of meaningful relationship. And there's Carlos. He's been working here for almost a year now. He started as part of the prison work relief program, unloading trucks twice a week. And this is only one of 12 prisoners that didn't disappear during a freak show storm. Fuck. I fucked it up. It was going so good. Okay. Sorry, I end up needing water. Doing constant reading is not possible. Because then you end up getting thirsty. Okay, anyway. He was one of the 12 prisoners that didn't disappear during a freak snowstorm last December. But that's none of my business. Carlos did his time, and when they released him, he came to work here, cleaning the store and unloading trucks. He comes in six times a day for each of his 30-minute shifts. Now that I think about it, then, not exactly sure what he does during those shifts. The store's never clean, and trucks only come twice a week, exclusively during the daylight hours as per an arrangement following the incident. Maybe one day I'll ask Carlos what he goes, or what he does for the owners. All I know is that he's the closest thing to a friend that I have here. When Carlos approached me at the register last night, I knew something unusual was going on. He was sweating bullets, pale and on the verge of passing out. He kept glancing back at the man in the suit that had wandered into the store and was standing next to the frozen drink machine. He told me that he needed to talk. Now. I told him, go ahead, but he refused to say anything unless I followed him into the freezer. I usually hate to leave the front of the store unwatched. We have the occasional shoplifter. Plus, there was that one time Rocco got in and made off with two cases of cigarettes. But Carlos seemed serious, so I made an exception for him. Once we were in the sub-freezing safety of the walk-in cooler, Carlos asked me if I'd seen the guy in the suit. And I said, yeah, I saw him. He asked if I knew the guy. And I said, yeah, I'd seen the guy around town. His name is Kiefer. He was running for some kind of office, I can't remember which one, and stopped by the gas station every now and then. He drove an old black SUV that only took premium. I didn't know him much from in town, but he was definitely local. His picture was framed in my high school's trophy case for one of those sports competitions we had won years and years before I got there. We only had so many things to... so many words around us. We only have so many things to be proud of, I suppose. I know of Kiefer, but I weren't exactly acquaintances. I told all this to Carlos, who shook his head and said, no, that can't be Kiefer. I said, why not? Carlos told me, that can't be Kiefer, because Kiefer's been dead for 2 days. His body's in the trunk of my car right now. And that's when things started getting weird. It was a very strange night between the hand plants, Farmer Jr., and the cultist that wouldn't leave me alone. And I hardly had any time to collect my thoughts. And of course, there was the Carlos situation. I'll get back to that and tell you all about it, but I gotta grab some coffee. That's literally what it says in the thing. I'm not. You're just following with the plot, guys. I'm just sorry. Then it says go to part 3. Oh. Yo, I mean, I could go get some coffee, realistically speaking. But I mean, drinking coffee, it's 12:50. I shouldn't get coffee. That's a bad idea. It's late. Drinking coffee right now is a bad idea. This is chill. We're chill. We're here to chill, not wake up. You know what I mean? All right. Chat this. Wow. I mean, I was considering doing the next part, but that's a long part, chat. Like, look at this. Oof. I don't know about that one, guys. That in comparison to part two, which was this, and part one, which was this. I don't know, man. Part three is like part two, part one. Together. Shit. That's a lot. Fuck. Alright, gamers. I'll try. For you. For you! No promises on actually finishing it, though. But I'll try. Okay. I'm gonna set the tone really weird, okay? We're gonna do some weird freeform tone work. I don't know why. I just want to. Okay. We're in a car right now, right? You know, it's raining. We're gonna get real low. We're gonna get real sad. Not, maybe not sad, but we're gonna get real somber, okay? Melancholy, maybe. There are times when this world drifts so close to the fabric of reality that I can hear something calling me from beyond the veil. Sometimes when I get too close, I can feel that thing on the other side tugging at the corners of my mind. I'm worried about Carlos. He doesn't seem to be taking this so well. In case you don't know, I work at that shitty gas station at the edge of our small town. And weird things have been happening for as long as I've been here. I finally started to fuck up.
Actually, that's the beginning of the next sentence here.
I finally started to tell some of my stories, and if you haven't caught up yet, I would like to invite you to read part one and part two.
So it's just the thing that links this stuff up. It's fine, it's whatever.
In case you guys aren't aware, this is off of the No Sleep Reddit, and you know what I could actually do, chat? I just realized something. I know it doesn't fit the aesthetic of the rain, but I could totally add a filter on my mic to, like, you know, give it, like, a good reading tone, too. Because this is just, you know, the normal, you know, compressor stuff. Is there some kind of, like, reading filter that the creepy pasters are, end up using? Do they use some kind of, like, echo or some kind of reverb that I don't know about? It feels right. I think this works fine. I think if it works fine, it works fine. But I mean, are you sure you don't want me to read like this?
In case you don't know, I work at the shitty gas station at the edge of our small town.
You sure you don't want that? Okay. All right, fair. That's fair. Yeah, valid. Alright, cool. I agree. That would have been a bad idea. Too much effort on the vocals. Alright. Let's continue. Back into reading mode, chat. When I returned to work after my post yesterday, I was delighted to find a stack of receipt paper sitting neatly on the register counter. With notes written in my own shaky handwriting. I don't remember writing all these notes, but then again, I don't remember a lot of things. That's actually pretty relatable. It
It's possible that I'm working too hard. Maybe the fumes are coming from beneath the gas station or playing tricks on me. Or perhaps it's just another side effect of my condition. At any rate, I'm not one to look a gift horse in the mouth. Or any other animal. Or any other orifice. Or yeah. Anyway. Admittedly, my handwriting isn't the best. At times, the scratches on the receipt paper become nearly illegible. So if anything herein seems unbelievable, it's probably because I copied wrong. With that in mind, just, you know, here it is. 7 o'clock. It's getting dark earlier these days. 7:30. Farmer Jr. came into the gas station tonight, asking about the hemp plants. I told him they weren't there anymore. He left his phone number scribbled on the back of a coupon for 15% off bulk pig feed from an online retailer. I think he's trying to send me a message. 9 o'clock. I think maybe some kids are trying to play a prank on me. I found a lawn gnome behind the pork rinds. I don't think much about it, but I put him in a box on the counter. Anyway, I found another matching lawn gnome in the soda case. That was something. And then I added it to this one box as well. Okay. Sorry.
Totally changed shift. I totally changed the shift in tone. God damn it. I'm so bad at consistency. Fuck. Alright, let me retry 9 o'clock. I kind of fucked up 9 o'clock so far. 9 o'clock.
I think maybe some kids are playing a prank on me. I found a lawn gnome behind the pork rinds. I didn't think much about it and put him in a box behind the counter. But then I found another matching lawn gnome in the soda can. Wait a second.
I just realized something.
We're a gas station employee. 9 o'clock. I think maybe some kids are playing a prank on me. I found a lawn gnome behind the pork rinds. I didn't think much about it and put him in a box by the counter. But then I found another matching lawn gnome in the soda case. Added this one to the box as well. It wasn't until, however, then I noticed that a third and fourth lawn gnome, that something shows up. I'd taken out the garbage and found the gnomes perched atop a branch of a tree next to the dumpster, staring down at me like a gargoyle. I used a chair and broom to knock them down and put them in the box with the other three. When I got back to my desk, I found a note on my chair and it was written in red ink. Simply said, I'm in the walls. I don't know who wrote it, but the paper smells like oranges and plumeria. What's plumeria? Is that a flower? Sounds like it'd be a flower. It is? Okay. Cool. I think it's a Pokemon? That makes sense. Okay.
10 o'clock.
There's a strange scratching noise coming from the tiles above the cash register. Your Rocco and his brood may have infiltrated the building again. 11 o'clock. Farmer Jr. called the store. He asked about the hand plants, and I assured him that they weren't there anymore. And if they showed up again, I'd call him. I think he's beginning to suspect that I'm lying. 12 o'clock. One of the cultist recruits wandered in from the community in the woods. They hate it when I call them cultists. I know the recruits aren't really supposed to interact with the outside world, but from time to time they'll sneak into town. You know, never any further than this gas station. And buy some cigarettes. But
No, they aren't supposed to try and recruit new members until they graduate to the honorable senior cultist status. But this one isn't a very good cultist. I know they aren't supposed to have names, but I'm gonna call this one Marlboro. Let you guess why. I like it. Sorry, chat. I was adjusting. Marlboro stayed in the store for at least half an hour, trying to convince me to go back to the compound with him. They hate it when I call their home a compound. He tried to appeal to my logical side, but I let him know politely, but firmly, that I was not interested in logic. I can't remember when he left. 2 o'clock. I found myself digging again. Sometimes on slow nights, I let myself drift. My mind goes somewhere, and when I come to, I wonder, where was I just now? Who was that controlling my body while I was gone? My body does these things. I've done so many things, like, a lot, I guess. It does stuff. I fucked up and I was trying to fucking save it. I'm gonna restart that sentence, guys. I'm so sorry. I tried. My body did those things. Wait, there should be a period here. Okay, that's why. Because they hecked up their grammar. That's why I hecked it up. It's not me that's the problem. It's the goddamn the children. Wait, what's the line? God damn it. It's not me that's the problem. It's you guys know the meme. It's an old joke. It's not a joke. It's a movie quote. I don't know. You get it. Anyway, this has gone way overboard. I'm just gonna go back into immersion mode. Gas station. My body did those things. I've done so many things so many times before that I guess it's just learned how to do them without me. My body restocked the cigs, and my body rotated the frozen drink machine, scrapped the mold off the bottoms of the ice buckets, and emptied the rat traps, and somewhere along the way, my body found a shovel, went out back, and started digging a hole. Actually, I shouldn't say my body started digging. My body has been digging this hole off and on for the last few months. Usually I come to after a few shovelfuls. This time I had another foot deep before I snap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. Fuck. This time I added another foot deep before I snapped back to reality and asked myself, what the hell am I doing? 3:30. I just noticed a door at the end of the hallway past the walk-in cooler. How long have I worked here and never noticed that door before? It seems disappointingly ordinary as far as doors go. Except for the fact that it's warm to the touch and it feels like it's vibrating, but I tried the handle, but it's locked. When I got back to the register, I noticed a man in a trench coat standing outside beyond the gas pumps, just outside the reach of our lights, dangerously close to the road. Wow. I can't tell if he's looking at me or if he's looking past the building at the woods on the other side. I wish he wouldn't stand there like that. Stoic and still, with his arms reaching down past his knees. Scratching against the tiles in the ceiling over the counter is getting louder, by the way. 3:45. The man came into the store, rolling a large white chest. Forgot the ice part. Darn. The man came into the store, rolling a large white ice chest behind him. He had sunken blue eyes, wiry hair coming from his nose and ears, and long bony fingers, paper-thin skin revealing every blue and green vein beneath that succulent dermis.
He uses the word dermis for things. He wore a... Motherfucker got a goddamn thesaurus, must have been. He wore a bowler cap and smelled like milk. I had definitely never seen him around here before. He asked if we would be interested in partnering up with him. He sold ground meat at discount prices. But I told him that our store doesn't do well with the fresh foods category, recommending he try a hand at making jerky. Before he left, he scooped about a pound or so of raw ground beef from the ice chest onto a piece of parchment paper and gave it to me as a sample. Once he'd left, I took the meat to the cooler, where I found another lawn gnome waiting for me. Put the gnome into the box with the other seven. 4 o'clock. Carlos just told me something very strange about Kiefer. 4:30. There was a kid named Spencer Middleton who went to the same high school as me and Kiefer. Spencer was just a year ahead of me, but looked much older and acted much younger. I live in a small town, and small towns get bored. For entertainment, some turn to gossip, some turn to more sinister pastimes. The latter often fueled the former. There were rumors around town that Spencer liked to torture and kill animals. Rumors that Spencer's parents and siblings always locked their bedroom doors and when they went to sleep at night. The rumors didn't slow down any after the fire at Spencer's house. Spencer was the only one who escaped unscathed. I once saw him just gleefully stomp on a lizard. Just throw his head back and laugh. Some short time after that, his house caught fire for the second time. Spencer left town. The story went that he'd gone off and joined the army. I didn't know what to think about that, so I simply didn't think about that. I would have been perfectly happy to never think about that, but after all these years, I'm forced to. Because Spencer Middleton just came into the store and bought a cup of coffee. Sitting in one of the booths, talking to Kiefer. Marlboro's back. He asked if I could spare some time to talk about his fake religion. They hate him when I call it a fake religion. I told him he had to leave. He seemed a little upset. 4:45. Spencer and Kiefer sat around for a while and didn't buy anything but two cups of coffee. When they finally left, I let Carlos know. He'd been hiding under a blanket in the walk-in cooler, though I can't really understand why. Carlos explained to me exactly what happened. He finished his shift a couple nights ago and had just left the gas station when he saw Kiefer's SUV pull over in a ditch at the bottom of the hill. Carlos, being the good guy he is, decided to check and see if Kiefer needed any help. He says that when he pulled up and got out of the car, he could hear what sounded like a loud crunching noise coming from just beyond the tree line. Carlos went to investigate. That's when he saw something. When I asked Carlos what he saw, he just started speaking Spanish in a fast, panicked sort of way. I don't speak Spanish, but I nodded empathetically. The only word I could pick up was Draga, which is the name of a liquor we carry. Whatever it was that Carlos saw, it made him race back to his car as fast as he could go and back out. Fuck. Yeah. Whatever it was that Carlos saw, I made him race back to his car as fast as he could and back out quickly without looking. And that's when he ran over Kiefer. Carlos is a good guy, but here he was in a bad situation. He stopped long enough to get out, check on Kiefer, and confirm that he was definitely dead. There was nothing he could do to change that fact. It was an accident, but Carlos was on parole. There was that thing in the woods, and Carlos had to make a decision. So he heaved the body into the trunk and drove off. Carlos took me to his car and showed me the body. I can confirm 100% that it was Kiefer in the trunk of his car. Not just because of his unmistakable face, but also because of his phone and wallet that were in his pockets. Sip break.
Oh my god.
Water is up there. Alright, chat. 5 o'clock. I finally got tired of the scratching and pulled our ladder out of the storage to see what the raccoons were doing in the ceiling. But when I pushed back the tile, the only thing up there was another gnome. That makes one dozen so far. 6 o'clock. The man in the trench coat is still outside. The cultist came back in, demanding an audience with me, insisting that if I would just listen to him, I would see that his reasoning is superb and flawless. That I'd be a fool to not join him in the perfection of logic and nirvana that is his belief structure. I agreed to listen to his pitch if he would agree to ask the man in the trench coat to leave. Our hasty verbal contract in place, I steeled myself to listen. Honestly, he did make a few good points. But I suppose that's to be expected. From a viral thought experiment strong enough to convince perfectly normal people to abandon their real lives and go live in a commune in the woods past the shitty gas station on the edge of town. They call themselves the Mathematists. Nope. Do that better. They call themselves the Mathematists. They believe that humankind exists to fulfill two moral imperatives: to decrease suffering and to increase happiness. A successful life increases happiness more than suffering. A decent life decreases suffering more than happiness. How good a person is can be determined by the spread between the happiness increased and the suffering decreased. Obviously, if the individual has a negative spread, that is, if they've increased happiness less than they've increased suffering, or if they've... What is happening now? I'm just gonna retry that one. How good a person is can be determined by the spread between the happiness increased and the suffering decreased. Obviously, if the individual has a negative spread, that is, if they've increased happiness less than they've increased suffering, or if they've decreased suffering less than they've decreased happiness, then that means, very simply, that the individual's bad. Therefore, if an individual causes a tremendous amount of happiness and suffering, one can simply determine which was higher and use this perfect rubric to determine whether that individual was good or bad. Simple, right? Well, the Mathematists believe that the world has been going on about good and bad in the wrong way. For eons, we've been attempting to increase happiness, when instead we should have been focusing on decreasing suffering. As happiness is a fluid concept, and the more happiness you create, the harder it is to sustain, as happiness is a clear set of diminishing returns. Suffering, however,
is consistent. Suffering results from happiness coming to an end. Suffering is pure and eternal. For mathematics, it's supremely good. They must simply end all suffering. That is why the mathematists are working on a bomb to destroy the entire planet. By ending all life on Earth, they end an infinity of suffering into the future. With every life they avert, an entire lineage of people that would be born into a life of suffering will no longer. Every death is preemptive mercy killing. Every happy moment will no longer occur pales. Every happy moment that will no longer occur pales in the face of all the sad moments that are likewise prevented. And so, as Marlborough explained, their murder cult believes that killing is a kindness. I told him that his ideas were stupid and that he was stupid and that he was now told to go tell the man with the trench coat to go away, and I didn't like that. 6:30. The phone rang. This is strange for two reasons. First, because it was not the landline. It was the cell phone, even though we do not get cell phone service way out here. And second, because it was the cell phone. The one that I took off of Kiefer's body. I'll admit I was stuck in a bit of a moral quandary ever since Carlos confided in me. On one hand, Carlos had killed someone. On the other, it was an accident, and Carlos's parole officer may not see it that way. I thought I would have had more time to figure this out, but when the cell phone started ringing, I knew I had to make a decision. I answered. I didn't speak first. The voice on the other line was one I recognized.
You have something that belongs to my boss.
It was Spencer Middleton. His cell phone is in his wallet. I answered.
What? No. We don't care about that shit.
Wait, no. I'm gonna give him more emphasis and more passion. What? No, we don't care about that shit. We can buy more phones. We know what we want. He was right. I did. It was an accident, I explained.
We know. We want to make a deal. You give it back, and we pretend this whole thing didn't happen.
Can we do that? Absolutely. 7:30. Carlos came in for his shift half an hour late, and I explained the deal to him. He wasn't thrilled, but as laid it out very clearly, he didn't have a choice. We parked Carlos's Camry behind the gas station near the growth of hand plants and made a point to stand far enough away to not get our ankles grabbed. Kiefer's SUV drove up a few minutes later. Spencer was driving. He and Keith got out without a word, sized us up, and opened the back of their vehicle. Carlos popped his trunk. Kiefer and I stared at each other, keeping eye contact the whole time while Carlos and Spencer transferred the body from one vehicle to the other. Spencer had a tarp and a blanket ready to wrap everything up. When it was over, Kiefer put a hand on my shoulder and whispered in my ear,
"You done good."
Then they left. Carlos started crying as it went back inside the store. It was almost daytime. That's when the new part-timer was supposed to take over. 8:00. Is my voice... I feel like I'm too dry. I need to drink more water. My voice is constantly getting drier, and I'm getting more tired because I'm putting myself in a relaxed state. Hold on. Oh, we're actually almost done, chat. We're almost there. You can do it.
I knew we could do it all the time.
Eight o'clock. The new part-timer's late, and I'm overdue for a lunch break. I made the best of my extra time here by putting price stickers on all the lawn gnomes, ringing them up as miscellaneous grocery for $9.99 each, and I've already sold a couple. I'm a really good employee. 8:30. I went to the bathroom and saw a man standing there with his jeans on his ankles. He wore red and white checkered boxers and a cowboy hat. He smiled when he saw me and simply said in a somewhat sing-song voice, "Come on, man, come on with it." I took the opportunity to ask him something that has been burning at the back of my mind. Do you know, is everything going to be okay? The bathroom cowboy took a second to think, and he pulled up his pants, fastened his enormous belt buckle, and walked past me. Spurs clinking against the bathroom tile. He stopped for a second when he was right next to me and said plainly, "I appreciate it." Then he left. I honestly have no idea what that means. These are the entirety of the receipt paper notes. I did make a point to continue keeping this journal. I think this would be a healthy way of chronicling the weird events at the gas station. Maybe this will even help with my condition. I don't know. Next time something strange happens, maybe I'll come back and write more. Until then, I guess this is, should be continued. Oh, and then he goes on to make an edit about correcting something about, "Sorry, upon further inspection, I realized that some of the scribbles on the receipt paper may have been transcribed incorrectly. I also made some adjustments to the spelling and fixed some typos. While I was at it, I added another typo for the observant reader. Lastly, upon advice of some of my readers, I removed the part where I listed Farmer Jr.'s social security number and address. I also..." Alright, that's probably for the best. "Also, special thanks to the reader that pointed out that Strega isn't even a Spanish word. I asked Carlos about it when he came in his fourth shift today, but Carlos simply looked at me blankly and told me that he doesn't speak Spanish." Oh, that's fair. Carlos, then why do you fucking speak Spanish when you were nervous that one day, Carlos? What the fuck? Jeez, Carlos. God, rude. So rude. You know what, chat? I think that might be it for me at this cozy corner time. If that's cool with you guys. Are we all now nice and secure and chill and ready for sleep? Probably be a pretty good idea. Give it a shot if you want. If you still need content to see, I'll send you somewhere to D. Or if you want a suggestion that involves me, friend, I'll take you over to Dodger's stream, her VODs where we played World War Z. We did it earlier today. She streamed a little bit before I hit stream play. Anyway, I gotta pee soon, so I better hit raid on somebody. Alright, let me find somebody. Sorry. I'm pretty sleepy. Let's see. Who might be doing something interesting? You know what game is actually surprisingly fun was Forager. I've been playing that as like a chill game. It's not a bad chill game. But it's getting really busy worky. Maybe I shouldn't play it anymore. It's not as chill anymore when it's so busy working, you know what I mean? Ray Drax, is he streaming right now? I don't follow Draxer? Oh, wait, didn't he always do YouTube streams? Is that why? Oh, I think that is why, actually.
Yeah, that's why. Because he hadn't... Right, okay. Alright, chat. We'll raid Draxer. Very, very nice boy. Holy shit, Deggy! 10,000 bitteronis, man. Thank you very much. For you! Thank you very much, man. That's super sweet of you. Thank you. Hopefully you had a good night and a good time with that. Alrighty. Let me go ahead and type this for you guys here. Okay. Go hang out with Draxer. If not, you can go check out Dodger's VODs of the stream today. And just have a good time, okay? Alright. I'm gonna have this thing going. Alright, bye.
Oh, jeez.
Anyway, thank you again for stopping by, guys. It was a lot of fun.
I hope you had good a night. Good book club session with your reading. And how dare you copy my how dare you copy my book reading? Oh, that's okay. That's good, man.